First of all, thanks, Josh, for the great introduction, but more importantly for the T-shirt. I can tell you, I will wear this with great pride. Because as you were talking and people were announcing themselves, I was thinking about an old friend of mine. That friend being, I just screwed your microphone up. I was thinking about Tony Mazzocchi.
Yes,
sir. Tony, how instrumental he was.
Yep.
In Labor Fest, and how he and I, on so many occasions, would talk about the thing that we do worst in the labor movement is really record our struggles and what we do. We're so busy doing them that we don't record them properly. And films and songs and poems and cartoons and all the other things actually do capture our history and our culture and our essence and what we're all about. We really do need to do more of it because we have a great heritage. I mean, it's great. And the struggles of everyday men and women coming together to do uncommon things together and actually make history needs to be told more and more and more what we do, what our role in it is. Because, you know, I'm a student of history, a lot of the Civil War. And we frequently read about battles, and they pull out the generals. But those generals were really nothing without the foot troops that made the strategy and the tactics actually work. And it's the foot troops, the everyday people, that really get left out of things. And our history, when we have a film, or when we have a picture, or a song, or a poem, or a cartoon, really talks about our role. The role that we played in those struggles. And I can't really begin to tell you how important it is and how proud that I am to be associated with. So the first time Tony came to me and said, we're going to have a film fest, I knew, first of all, because he came, that I was going to participate. Before I knew what it was going to be, I knew I was going to be there because of Tony. And I'm sure he's up there right now. Looking down and saying, yeah, you're doing all right. You still got a long way to go, but you're doing all right, and I appreciate you. And, at some point, I hope we can do something for our friend Tony Mazzocchi. Excuse me, I have something in my eye. For our friend Tony Mazzocchi because of his role in Film Fest, but in just encouraging us to understand and embrace and celebrate our culture. And our heritage and our history. And so I want to thank you for doing all that. I think, you know, what you're doing right here is absolutely wonderful. I've been told, and it's probably true, that this is the only conference of its kind in the world, where the only event that brings together the people who produce labor film festivals. And I believe that's true. And I also understand that we have representatives from 20 festivals here, from 11 states and 3 other countries. And I think that's incredible. And to all of you, I want to say welcome. Welcome here to the House of Labor, but welcome and thank you for all your work, what you do every day, because it enriches all of our lives and makes all of us a little bit better off. Now, I don't have to tell you that I love labor films and love film festivals. I guess the reason is, well, why, Rich? Because every time I say I do something, people say, well, why? And I think it's because when you watch them, suddenly you're watching lives and struggles come together, something that you might otherwise not see. Because the percentage of people that actually participate in those struggles, whatever form they happen to take, is very, very few. So you might find yourself with a new view of your own life and your own struggles. And I believe that you probably produce more activists than any of us really know. Because people come and they watch the film and they get inspired and they say, I want to do something about it. And they end up, whether it's just going in a phone bank and making calls or going door knocking or getting more active in their local union or in their local community. I think you inspire a lot of that. And I think art does that in a lot of different ways. It brings alive the past and it brings alive the world around us and allows us really to imagine a future that we really might not dream of or think about on our own. So you help us think about a future, a better future, where struggle can actually lead to success, and success can lead to change, and change can lead to a better world, a more just, fair, and sane world, where workers really do get respected for what they do. They really do honor the work and the services that we perform that are absolutely necessary for this country or any country to succeed, and yet they go unnoticed every day. I had a farm in Pennsylvania, and it's the most incredible view. I mean, when you walk out the front door, it's an incredible view, and I walk in and out of that front door 1,000 times, and it's only once in a while that I really stop and just look at things and appreciate what's there. And really, I don't know if you really realize this, but that's what you do. You capture those kind of moments and you allow all of us to appreciate them and to experience them and to feel them and to share in sadness with workers and happiness with workers and to see and feel and taste what struggle really is all about. So when you create film festivals, you really do help build movements, and you aid in organizing drives, and you aid in a bunch of other things that you probably aren't even aware of yourselves, the breadth and extent and the depth of where you're going and what you're able to do with your work. See, I believe right now that American history is at a turning point, and there's no guarantee what's going to happen next, but what I want and what I pray is that we'll be inspired to create a new future for ourselves. You know, a future that's built on activism and collective action. And that's why your work, again, is so very, very important. And art always has been a successful part of our movements. We had a fascinella outside. It's now on loan. It's moving around. But every day I used to walk past that, and I used to stop and give it a glance. Or if I was at the elevator, I'd actually turn and look at that thing. Because that painting, large, fascinating, was just 1,000 little struggles were going on in that painting, if you focused on any different section of it. And it used to just sort of give me another little jolt to go on when, after you come out of a meeting, you had people sitting around like this, and they say, yes, 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 we have a problem. Yes, 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 this is what we do. And they walk out the door and do nothing. You know, sometimes even leaders need to get a little cup of encouragement. And old Ralph used to do that for me, and he will do it again, I know. The other thing I just say is, you know, what you do isn't easy work. I mean, when we look at the product, it looks so wonderful and uplifting and everything, but I know it's not easy, and you know that better than I do, that selecting films is only one small piece of putting it together a festival. There's the question of raising money, how you do it, how others do it, so you can help each other, and how do you attract audiences, and how do you turn out crowds, and how do you to build from year to year, and what are others doing that's succeeding so that you can share it with one another. Because activism is really an inexact science. Trust me, after 40-some years in the labor movement, I can attest to that. And activists like you, but you're always coming up with fresh ideas, that infusion of fresh ideas. And You know what I think about? I came from a union, the mine workers, and for a number of years we were 100% male, totally male dominated in the mines. And then after I got in the mines, women started coming in, and they had a tough time. Those first women in the mines were 10 times tougher than any of the men that were harassing them and giving them crap and, you know, doing different stuff. But you know what they did for us? There was this new, fresh infusion of ideas, a new way of collaborating, a new way of coming together. And they probably saved our union from just falling off the edge of the table into oblivion because of their ideas, their fresh ideas and their new way of collaborating and the sharing information and the way they were able to work together. And, you know, males sort of cluster into these little enclaves and hold stuff, and they busted that open in my union. And it was a very, very good thing. And I look back on it and I'm happy that it happened. And I befriended one of the women that came in, and she ended up being an officer in my local union. And one of the toughest people I've ever been around. And she was just really an inspiration. And that's what you guys do. I mean, you come up with new ideas, and you push us, and you make us do things that we're uncomfortable with sometimes. But that's like the beauty of it. And quite frankly, that's really what we need. You know, we need to have fresh ideas and get out of our comfort zone and be pushed. And you're doing the best thing that for a movement that could ever happen. And that's making us look at those new ideas and pushing us to do it. So I'm glad you're going to find out here amongst each other what works best. And I'm glad you have a chance to hopefully share your ideas back and forth. We're proud to support the process, and I promise you, as long as I am involved in the labor movement, we will be supporting, not just with lip service, but with other resources as well, this process, because I absolutely believe it is fundamentally essential for any union or any movement to be able to grow is to have a vibrant section like we're talking about here. So I hope you all find some information and some you get inspired, and you build on your work back home. And as your festivals spread and grow throughout the country and throughout the world, our movement and working families will spread as well. So we work and we grow in parallel, and just keep up the good work. And I guess I'll leave you with this. You know, I grew up in a small coal mining town. We were dirt poor. My dad worked 5 days a month, like the other miners there. Not a week, a month. And they would work you Monday 1 week, Tuesday the next, Wednesday the next, so you could never get an unemployment check and you could never get another job. You get cynical. Now, don't get me wrong, we didn't know that we were poor, because everybody was poor and it was all on the same level, except for the company people who had much bigger houses and were segregated from us and weren't allowed to play with us. And we were like the other side of the tracks to them. And so that sort of showed us what the wall was. But I remember us singing songs. I remember one guy that we had that was an artist that would draw caricatures, and we'd all get together at the local union hall and kids, and he'd draw caricatures, a little kid, and it was like the prize thing that you had. When he decided to draw one of you, he showed it to everybody, and you took it home, and quite frankly, I still have one of me. It occurred, he probably drew it in 55 or 56, that's 1955 or 56, not 1855 or 56, although it could be that too. And that gave me some sense of identity and some sense of hope, and it allowed us to dream of a better day. and of a better way. And a lot of us, because of those type of things, actually got lucky and we were able to end up at a place like this because of those things. So I just want to thank you, because the work you do goes so far and reaches so deep and touches so many that you never know. But I can tell you it's happening. And I want to say thanks. And I want to say keep up the good work. Keep up, do more of it, not less of it. And for those of us that start to become an anchor on you, you know, like kick me in the shins and say, hey, keep up and let's get out of here. Come on. Because I appreciate that. God bless you and have a great festival. And know that we appreciate what you do 365 days a year, not just today. God bless.